Pag sinasabi ng iba, hinahanap niyo daw po ay digmaan. Pero ba't hindi po kayo magkompromiso?
Isinusuka ko ang digmaan, Joven. Pero ang kompromiso.
I chose General Luna because of how gender bias is greatly emphasized in the film. The film was produced by E.A. Rocha and directed by Gerald Tarang. The lead actors were John Arcelia, Aaron Villaflor, Mon Confiado, Archie Alemania, and Epi Kizan. With John Arcelia as the main character of the film, acting as the title itself, who depicts General Antonio Luna's leadership of the Philippine Revolutionary Army during the Philippine-American War. Aaron Villaflor as the journalist, writer, and narrator of Antonio Luna's life. Mon Confiado played the character of Emilio Aguinaldo, who is the first president of the First Philippine Republic. However, the Americans didn't want to refer him as a president, instead calling him General-in-Chief. Archie Alemania's role as a cavalryman who joined General Luna to Cabanatuan. Epi Kizan played the character of Apolinario Mabini, the former Prime Minister of the First Philippine Republic and former Secretary of Foreign Affairs, who served as the advisor of the President Emilio Aguinaldo. The movie was all about the set during the Philippine-American War, and Luna follows the life of one of the Philippine history's most brilliant soldier, General Antonio Luna, as he tries to lead his countrymen against colonial masters, new and old, and to rise above their own raging disputes to fulfill the promise of the Philippine Revolution.
Wala ba tayong karapatang magbuhay ng malaya?
America is destined for better deeds, and who will, what can, set limits to our onward march?
Mapamalawak natin ang ating ekonomiya kung makikipagkalakal tayo sa kanila.
Negosyo o kalayaan, bayan o sarili, pumili ka!
The cultural elements were presented in the film. Their norms were just like our old ancestors and fellow Filipinos. Eating at the right time like lunch and dinner, they greet each other whenever they travel from place to place. They show politeness to elders and show respect to each other. Considering the time, you will see in the film that most Filipinos do their jobs well and with ease. The structures such as the house of the president captured the Filipino culture, where the design will make you think it's a Philippine idea. Values were greatly observed, the main character does his job well with integrity, and people are being polite to their supreme. They also show kindness and discipline.
Hindi gusto ng ilang politiko at negosyante ang iyong pamamalakan. Masyado ka daw mayabang. Marahas.
Walang nakaangat sa batas, kahit na presidente.
General, baka may makadinig.
Hindi makinig sila!
Baliw ka na ni Galina. Nagagawin natin sa kanya.
Subukan mo na bang huliin ang hangin?
The women characters played so well that their acts look like not directed or scripted. They portray the women based on the old times and dressed well according to the Philippine culture. They are not that important as of the timeline of history because women were not empowered yet and being ignored most of the time. Men are so entitled, that is why I said gender bias is greatly presented in the film. Their acts are very natural, that is also according to the attitude and norms of Filipino men back in time. The acts of the women and the men in the film are accurate based on my study from history. There was no presence of homosexual characters in the film, as the movie is all about the war. The movie exceeds my expectations. Antonio Luna was a man with a tumultuous personality. He was honorable, patriotic, dignified, and principled, but he was also arrogant and irritable. But he did not hesitate to use violence. General Luna is a well-made movie representation of a man's life as a soldier during his country's greatest crisis, while also seeing the birth pangs of its origin as a nation after centuries of colonial control. As the patriotic and aggressive general who navigates the muddy and difficult roads of war and politics, veteran actor General Serial gives a strong performance. In this well-acted play, magnificent combat scenes and historical clothes lend color and spectacle, although Luna's childhood should have been included to give the picture more depth and closure. What is presented is enough. This film is watchable and engaging, and it serves as a showcase for Philippine cinema's continued development, as well as a fitting monument to one of the country's finest and most captivating heroes.
Sabihin mo sa ating mga kababayan na hindi nakakamit ang kalayaan sa pag-aaruga sa kanilang mga mahal sa buhay. Kailangan nilang magbayad.
Ano pong kabayaran?
Dugo at pawis. Kailangan nilang tumalon sa kawalan.
Isang direksyon lang pag ahumto! Huwag aaksihin ang bala! Huwaga! Tugang mga kababayan!
Si Antonio Luna ay malupit, abusado, mayabang.
Hindi mo maaaring magkaroon ng gantong gulo sa pagitan ng kapwa Pilipino.
Si Luna ang pinakamahusay kong general.
Mga kapatid, mayroon tayong mas malaking kaaway kaysa mga Amerikano. Ang ating sarili.